Harry Wright. Good luck.
Surprise.
Sophie, why haven't you told me you've invited your dad?
I haven't told him because I wanted it to be a surprise.
Well, he's going to go mad when you tell him. Donna's absolutely going to kill you when she finds out.
By the time she finds out, it'll be too late. I feel like there's a part of me missing. When I meet my dad, everything will fall into place.
Thank you. about you? It was over 20 years since I last saw you.
I always want a charm, I haven't changed a bit. Still a handsome boy.
And you were better with each passing summer. And this cannot be little Isabella.
You know me?
Last time I saw you, you were a little girl on your father's knee. How is Nando?
He's not very strong, but seeing you put many years of him.
I doubt that. He said I'd be the death of him.
So, I'm confused. How do you two know each other?
Started here for a summer job many years ago.
And I lost it for a week. And your mother and father, they took me in and treated me like I was one of their own.
Yes, you went from the Hotel Islands with Donna.
How is Donna? In fact, I got an invitation from someone I don't even know. Sophie, who I presume is her daughter. In fact, I don't really know what I'm doing here.
That's why he came back. That's so romantic. I see what Donna saw in you. You are a poet.
No, nothing is grand. In fact, I'm an architect. The first real design I did for her, we sat and we talked about her dream house. It was huge. I joked with her we could live on either side and never see each other. Are you still in the old house, Consuelo?
Yes, next to the bay.
Well, I'd love to come and surprise Fernando if he's there now.
He should be waiting to see us, buddy.
Well, I'll get sorted here and meet you two up there.
Hi, may I help you?
Ah, yes, we're here for the wedding, you see.
Bill Anderson.
Bright! Harry Bright!
Sam Carmichael. You are expecting us.
Oh my goodness, yes!
And you must be Donna's daughter.
Yes, I thought you looked familiar. Is it Sophia?
It's Sophie.
Well, would you mind if we see our rooms before we see your mother?
Sure.
I'd just like to freshen up a tad before the big reunion.
No, I mean, yes, but come this way.
So can we see Donna now?
Listen, I sent the invite. My mom's always talking about you guys in the good old days. I thought what an amazing surprise to her. You're all going to be at my wedding.
Sophie, I can't be here. The last time your mother saw me, she said she never wanted to see me again.
That was years ago. Please, it would mean a lot to me.
Look, I can see you've gone to lots of trouble to get us all here. May I suggest we reconvene down in the harbour?
Nope.
Why?
Well, he sees them. It's an adventure.
Listen, when I sent the invite, it was a long shot that he didn't reply. Now you've come all this way for a wedding. There must be some special reason you could come here.
You're a little minx, you know that? You're just like your mother. Look, it's Donna!
No. She can't know you're here. Promise me you won't tell anybody that I invited you. I've got to go. Just please.
You got it.
It's a promise. Might regret it, but okay.
Oh my God. This cannot be happening.
I'm spontaneous.
Well, what about you?
I just wanted to see the islands. You know how much it meant to me.
All right, well, I'm going to arrange for a boat to take you back to the mainland.
No need, Donna. I've got a boat.
You do? Good. Get on it. Anchors away.
Wait, so you mean leave the island?
Yes.
So you mean leave the island right now?
Yes.
You mean this very second get off the island?
Yes, I said go!
Donna! Hey, Donna. It's good to see you.
Where's Sophie?
I haven't seen her, Mom.
Oh, I must see her now. I found myself off the nearest cliff.
Late, darling, late. Now, ta-da!
Well, that's all I need. Talk about the past coming back to haunt you.
Rosie brought them. I can't believe you keep it in your car.
Oh, give it here and girl, I never want to see it again.
What the?
My thing, it's just, I can't talk about it.
You're beginning. You aren't making any sense. In fact, you're making more sense than usual.
All my life, it's been tapping me on my shoulder. Now, the day before my daughter's wedding, they show up. Oh, it's like some horrible trick of fate. Why was I so stupid?
You're beginning to scare me now. What is it?
You can't talk about it. It's just, it's all my fault. I was so stupid.
Whatever happened to our old Donna, life and soul of the party?
just in case. We were so young.
I don't know people who bought my books would ever say if they saw this outfit.
Hey girls, we should do a number tonight for the party. How about this?
Thank you.
know what I'm doing here?
Well, you know my mother, Donna.
Well, yes, I knew her quite well. I'm still none the wiser.
Well, you see, I was looking for some stuff for the wedding, and I found my mum's old diary, and it mentioned
you. Oh, maybe I should explain. You see...
Harry, are you all right?
Wait a minute. Anna, this is her. H.B. Headbanger. That's what they used to call me in the good old days. I bought this guitar for Donna. Cost me 10 old quid on my Johnny Rotten t-shirt. Who says we're not stuck in the mud now, eh?
Who says that?
Well, everybody really. I've been stuck in a can of rats since... Well, since the last time I was here, really. I met Donna on my sixth form grade trip to Paris, and she captivated me, you see, and as soon as she left, I jumped on a train and followed her to Greece. Rather spontaneously. But it wasn't meant to be.
It might be. How do you know?
She was in love with someone else, and so was I. I meant to stay in touch, I really did, but life moves on. They passed me by, all those great romances. They were, I felt, robbing me of my rightful chances. My picture clear, everything seems so easy. And so I dealt you the blow. One of us had to go. Now it's different, I want you to know.
She beat me to it. This was meant to be our dream house. I designed it for her.
If you loved it so much, why did you leave?
What she told you?
Nothing. She's never even mentioned you. The only things I know are from her diary.
Sophie, why am I here? Why invite me? Why now?
Oh,
Madame of Catholic. Oh, how's your mother?
She's fine, great.
This is bizarre. There's no mistaking that Dunna's daughter. Same eyes, same smile. Oh, I couldn't believe my memories this trip you brought back. Is your mother still singing?
Singing? My mom used to sing?
Your mother was a brilliant singer. That's who I met. She was touring with the Dynamos. Oh, and I fell for her. So I invited her back to my aunt's house and then I left for the summer.
Sounds like you really fell for her.
But by the time I got back, she said she'd been through with me. She said it was over. She said she had met someone else. So, although I knew that I loved her and she for me, it wasn't enough. So I started travelling.
Sounds like the travelling wasn't much fun. Sounds more like you were running away.
Sophie!
Thank you. strange.
I don't know what to do. I mean, should I wake Sky and tell him the wedding's off?
Is that what you want?
I don't know. I mean, how can I go through with this? Maybe I should, for Fernando's sake and his memory.
Yes, Fernando wanted to see you married, but this is about what you and Sky want, you know, having your future together.
Well, you did just find that man in your life, didn't you? You did all the marriage and baby stuff, you just had the baby and I turned out okay.
Hang on a minute, why are you having to go with me?
Because unlike you, I'm going to do things right. I love Sky and I want to be with him for the rest of my life. I refuse to be like you.
Like me?
A liar! I am not going to let my kids grow up not knowing who their father is. I have bust my gut trying to find out who I am, and all you have done is stop me out from finding the truth. I will be marrying Sky tomorrow. And if you don't approve, fine, don't come.
Sophie! Sophie!
So hard to find. I try to reach my
idea. Or maybe it was just the 2 hours sleep I got.
Well, Phil and I had our own fun.
You didn't.
No, we did not.
No,
no. We talked, called upon the old days, in fact. We're going to meet up a little later.
Well, I bumped into Pepper last night, which spiced up my evening. We talked and we actually have so much in common.
The only thing you have in common with him is that you're old enough to be his mother.
I'll have you know I looked very attractive for my age. Anyway, it's 3 hours to meltdown. Come on, girl, we've got a lot of work to do.
You? Work?
On my face, sweetie. A little repair and renovation.
Well, you'll need a trowel handy, and you'll need more than 3 hours to renovate and repair.
I swear, Rosie, one day I will swing for you.
What are you two doing here? Donna's gone ballistic. Sophie's gone missing again.
Skye, we help Rosie look for Sophie. I seriously need to exfoliate in the next 20 minutes or there won't be a wedding.
Oh, ho, 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 ho. Tanya, look at what the cat's dragged in.
Now then. It looks like you might be needing something else for breakfast.
Hi, Tanya.
Hello, Peppa.
Even you can't deny the chemistry between us.
Little boys that play with fire get their fingers burned.
Tanya, you Jezebel! Oh, no!
I've got something completely insane. All my my dads are here for our wedding, and they all think they're giving me away.
Oh, you're what?
Look, it's a long story, but I read Mom's diary, and I have three possible fathers.
But how are they here now?
I invited them. I thought I'd know my dad right away, but I didn't. And they're all going to hate me, and my mom's going to kill me, and you...
Hold on. You invited these guys? Didn't even tell me?
Look, I know I messed up. I'm sorry.
Sophie, is this what this big white wedding is about? You finding your father?
No.
I wanted to take folks to the mainland, but you insist on this circus so you can play happy family.
It's about knowing who I am, and I want to get married knowing who I am.
That doesn't come from finding your father. That comes from finding yourself. And the irony is, I was traveling to find myself, but I put everything on hold for you because I loved you and I wanted what you wanted. But now I don't know.
You don't know if you love me?
Of course I love you. I just wish you told me.
Sky!
I can't even look at you
Sky.
Right
now. Sky!
Sophie, you just need to go and find your mother.
She's here? Where the hell have you been? You've been worried sick.
You've been all over the place. You've been out of your mind.
What's wrong? Why are you upset? This is Pop Fernando.
Call here to give you all the talk about it.
Everything's gone wrong. I don't think I can do this anymore.
Everyone's so excited for your
big day. No, he thinks the wedding was a big excuse to find my father. We've just had a row, and I don't even think he's going to turn up. He clearly doesn't love me anymore.
Of course he loves you.
He absolutely adores you.
He's completely nuts for you.
He said that he doesn't understand me anymore. He can't even stand to look at me.
I can't believe he'd do such a thing. That's so awful. I don't understand how he could say that to you.
That is not a good sign, Sophie.
Why would he say such a thing?
Do you want me to speak to him?
Breaking up is never easy, I know.
Oh,
It's a long story, but please, Donna, just take it.
What is this?
I know you might have had to tighten your belt a bit over the years, but I'd just like to contribute something to the wedding.
Hand me this to cover the cost of 20 weddings. It's a lovely gesture.
Do you remember the last time you said that to me?
No, I never asked.
It was when I bought you the guitar. I remember thinking, those are the last words I'm ever going to hear of Donna Sheridan.
I'm sure I just said thank you and smiled politely.
You know, it's the first time I've heard you laugh since I arrived.
Well, I'm a little stressed, Harry. What do you expect?
It's understandable, but I miss the old Donna, my Donna, the carefree spirit.
Harry, this is a lovely gesture.
No more buts, Donna. I want you to have it. Summer land was soft and warm, the breeze was right, the Paris night did its best to please her. We took a chance, like we were dancing.
I've done everything I can to make you proud. You know that, don't you?
I'm going to tell you something. I invited you.
Sophie, you did what? What were you thinking?
Well, I just wanted to meet my dad to talk to him. I didn't mean to replace you. I didn't want to be so upsetting for you. I didn't hurt you. I'm sorry.
Oh, you could never hurt me. I love you, and I'm so proud of you.
Mom, will you give me away?
Of course.
I love you, Mom.
Maybe her dad wants to be there as well.
But you don't know who her dad is.
She told me I was her dad, and I want to be there for her.
Yeah, well, you can't. And you gave that up 20 years ago when you walked out.
Fine. I'll leave you alone. You win.
I win.
my hand. I apologize.
About this island of yours.
Are you for real? I'm not a bigamist.
Neither am I. I'm a divorced man who's loved you for 21 years. I've been dying to tell you how much I've loved you ever since I got in silence. How about it, Donna Sheridan? It's only the rest of your life.
Well,